how nicely we've come to the end of 2018. And suddenly I feel that as if the year has just flushed by. Did we have time to stop and think? Did we have time to rejuvenate? Did we have time to reflect on what we had done in 2017? Because 2019 is a harbinger and a follow-up of whatever seeds we have actually sown in 2017 or 2018. Now, what does this December hold for us? Now, this is my probably the last monthly prediction for 2018, because soon I am going to be telling you all what exactly you should be doing in 2019 so that the reaps are bountiful and you can have abundance of health, wealth and happiness. Well, December 2018 for you Virgos, health improves dramatically after the 16th as Mars moves away from a stressful 6 month transit. Still, it will not hurt to pace yourself until the 22nd. 90% of the planets are moving forward this month, so you will be making rapid progress towards your goals, though you may not feel it. The retrograde of Mercury, your ruling planet, makes you feel that you're not progressing even though you are. The planets are still mostly in the West, so as mentioned last month, this is a period for developing your social skills, tact, charm and diplomacy. Your way is probably not the best way this period, as there are factors that you are not aware of. Let go of self-will and undue independence and allow your good to come to you. The planetary power is still mostly in the lower half below the horizon of your chart. Again, like last month, cultivate harmonious emotional states and stabilize them at home. A strong home base will allow for career expansions later on in the year. Mars move out of your seventh house of love, which is a big plus on the romantic front for you. By now, a serious relationship has either broken off or transformed itself into something more pleasing. But love is going to be volatile for many years to come as Uranus moves into the seventh house again on the 30th. Uranus in the seventh house is not really a marriage aspect. Often it denies marriage, often it shows multiple serial marriages. Always it brings serial and unconventional relationships. Those working towards a second marriage, however, have wonderful opportunities until the 21st. Love awaits you at parties, social gatherings, and as you pursue your leisure activities. After the 22nd, you are in a party period, a period for leisure and fun, a cosmic holiday, which you actually deserve one. Finances seem strong and money is easily earned until the 21st. The money that comes will be happy money. Speculations are favorable. After the 21st, money comes through your work. A grand trine in your native element of Earth on the 15th and 16th not only enhances your health and energy, but also brings great financial rewards and windfalls. Opportunities and big items you can buy for the home. After the 21st, Venus, your money planet, travels with Neptune, the planet of intuition and love, which is your love planet. This suggests money from your spouse or partner, profitable intuitive flashes, and a possible business partnership or a joint venture. For your best days overall, for your most stressful days, or your best days for love, and for your money and honey, you'll have to visit my website. And remember, these are all general generic predictions for zodiacs, but to get your personalized chart made and knowing where your planets are situated and what are the mahadasas that are going to do to you, it's very important that 2019 should be a reflection of yourself. So to start the 2019 with great gusto, get your natal charts made, know where your planets are and how good they hold for you and what are the things that you need to negate and how you can mastermind your mahadasas.